Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So, in pre-lockdown times, I don't think I ever would have made a robe review video where the entire purpose of the video is to show you my robes, try them on, and tell you what I think of each one in each brand and kind of review them. But you guys have highly requested this video since I showed you just how many robes I have in my apartment tour video. And a lot of those comments and requests suggested that a lot of you are wearing your robes to do your work because after all, nowadays you can hold a board meeting with the camera turned off in your coziest bathroom robes. Why not show you what my favorites are, and I'll give you some tips and tricks to look for so that you can select the best robe depending on what you are looking for. So I'm going to start with my most recently purchased robe, which is from a brand called Yumi Kim. And this is probably my favorite robe that I own right now because it's so comfortable, slinky, and really comfortable on a hot day. I never owned a rayon robe before this one. It is a natural fiber and it's very swingy, so I find it doesn't stick to me or stick to my legs on a hot day. And I absolutely love the fabric. I think the fit is right as well. It's not enormous, you know, it's not overly drapey, but it's not tight either. And I just really love the blue blooms on it. Floral print robes, I tend to be a little bit picky because I find that a lot of them look quite dated. So it's most similar to this one that I have from Nordstrom Lingerie, and it's really nice as well, but it's a satin. So this isn't a robe that I would wear for the entire day because I find satin to just be less comfortable. However, I also do really like the lily print on it, as well as the nice mauve background and the detailing, which is the piping. So for like dress up, look pretty, just for breakfast, I like this one a lot. But in terms of like an overall favorite, I really have been loving this Yumi Kim one and just loving her designs generally and the quality of the fabrics and fit. Another really comfortable option that I'm always open to is jerseys. So I absolutely love Hebergé sleepwear. I think they make the highest quality luxurious sleepwear on the market. Whenever I can get my hands on really anything from them on sale, I do. And this is their classic robe, which is piping for detailing as well, and it's got a really nice stripe. I think they call it the Nordic stripe. And I have the matching nightgown, little nightie, and pajamas as well with this robe. So if you like matching sets, but you want them to still be really comfortable and just flattering, I find everything that they make really nice and flattering. I think Hebergé is a wonderful option. And you guys know I love to cook, and so I would say that this Hebergé one and then the next one I'm going to show you, I have gotten food stains, coffee stains. They wash really beautifully, so I think they're really nice robes to wear for several hours as well. And one of the oldest robes in my collection is this Ralph Lauren one. I feel like you guys have seen this one in many vlogmases. It's almost a little bit faded, but if you're looking for an overall robe that's going to be kind of all season, so it will keep you like a little bit warm if you're feeling chilly, but it's still a jersey fabric, so it's not going to make you sweaty or overheat you or anything like that. This Ralph Lauren monogram robe is wonderful, and it comes in quite a few colors, where I think I've had this one for about three, four years now, and before that I had a teal one that I had for many years as well. And I really like the shawl collar on this one, which is actually quilted, gives it a really nice soft detail and keeps you warm around the neck, which can be nice and cozy. And I find that it fits really well over something that might be a little bit bigger. For example, an oversized men's pajama style, whereas, you know, smaller robes like this tend to be made to go over something that's a little bit more skimpy. This one can pretty much go over anything. Looking for a robe that's going to be really quite fitted and close to the body, This is the most fitted one that I've ever owned. It's from Calvin Klein. It has a satin trim, but then the body of the robe is jersey as well. And it has a tie on the inside and then the belt on the outside. So it's quite close to the body. You definitely can't wear much underneath other than perhaps a nighty. Just a bit of a different look and approach than my other robes are. And something really random about this robe is it's definitely a staple in a lot of the wardrobe departments for TV shows, because I've seen this robe used as like the mom robe for a lot of characters on different shows on Netflix, and I always recognize it from the satin trim. It's kind of distinctive, but I will say it's very good quality. There's the tiniest little bit of wear to the fabric, but I've had this for at least 5 years as well. And then to finish off, I'm gonna show you my three more classic plush style robes. This category is really for when you're feeling quite cold and you just wanna feel warm and warm up on like a rainy day or something like that. This is a perfect robe. I think Barefoot Dreams does this kind of nubbly fabric really, really well, and it washes really, really well as well. I've had this one for several years now. If you're watching this video and you're shopping the Nordstrom anniversary sale, there is so much good Barefoot Dream stuff in that sale at much better prices than any other time in the year. And I will be making some videos about shopping the sale, so if there's anything in particular you would like to see content-wise or review-wise, because I've shopped the sale for many years now, so I'm thinking of maybe doing a favorites video so that I can guide you through the things that I think are real investments, because I think many of us will not be shopping the sale in as much of a lavish way. I thought it might be neat to share things that I have from 2-3 years ago that are consistently in the sale that I think are really fantastic investments that you'll get a lot of use out of. So this would be, I guess, a good example of that. I think a pretty pink is always a good choice, because when you're not wearing any makeup in the morning, it kind of brings a nice rosiness to your cheeks. That's kind of why I like floral prints for the same reason. I have this frette robe. I love frette sheets. They're my guilty pleasure indulgence. But this robe, I have to say, I think only makes sense if you have a pool, because it's really quite thick and bulky to wear, and it backs that up with the purpose that it is extremely absorbent, so you don't really need a towel at all if you have one of these robes. And it is beautifully made, just with the piping and the quality. I've washed it many times and it's still really nice, and it has a sateen kind of trim on the cuffs, so it does give you that hotel kind of feeling. But for me, you know, when I get out of the shower, I do towel off, so I tend not to use this all that much unless I'm around a pool. So I was thinking maybe I would bring this to Hawaii and it might live there at some point. But if you are someone who goes swimming a lot, then I think these are worth the money, because the quality of the toweling is really, really high. Finally, if you're looking for a robe that is good if you have oils or moisturizers on your skin, or your skin is still a little bit damp but not soaking wet, like with the frette one, I highly recommend Turkish robes. So there are a number of brands that make these. I'll link some options for you down below. This one is from Brooklinen, and you can see it is so much thinner than the frette one, so it's really, to me, it's quite different. Like, I wouldn't put this on and be soaking wet, because then the robe would still feel pretty wet to wear. But if for whatever reason you might have something on your skin that is still a little bit damp or oily feeling, I find a robe like this really nice to wear, because you don't feel as encased by it, but it's still, you know, nicely absorbent, and it washes really, really well as well. I've actually put this on many times after having self-tanner on that's still kind of, you know, it's soaked in, but it's not like fully set yet, and it'll leave marks all over it, but you can tell it's not stained at all. So I hope you're all doing well. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next installment on style.